Hey everybody, this is the Atlas Post. Today we're going to be talking about the Federal Pandemic Unemployment Compensation. So many of you are asking, what is that? Wait a minute, because you keep hearing about all this unemployment. It's like, who gets what? And they have all these different fine lines. Well, the Federal Pandemic Unemployment Compensation is just like it sounds. It is the federal portion. So this one was established by the CARES Act. Coronavirus Aid, Relief, and Economic Security Act, and it's the $2 trillion coronavirus emergency stimulus package from March 27th, 2020. It took place. So under the FPUC, this is when eligible people who collect certain unemployment insurance benefits, including regular unemployment compensation, will get an extra $600 in federal benefits each week through July 31st, 2020. Yes, you heard me right. That's an extra $600 in federal benefits each week through July 31st, 2020. So when the CARES Act started, it developed three new unemployment programs under the CARES Act. One was the Federal Pandemic Unemployment Compensation, which we are talking about today. The other is the Pandemic Unemployment Assistance Program, which is for the self-employed, freelancers, and independent contractors. And the Pandemic Emergency Unemployment Compensation, which extends the benefits for an extra 13 weeks after regular unemployment compensation benefits are exhausted. So how do you apply for the Federal Pandemic Unemployment Compensation and get an extra $600 per week for unemployment? Well, you do have to file a regular claim for benefits with the UI program. And UI is an unemployment insurance program. So you go through the portal in the state where you worked. So if you worked in California, you go through the California portal. New York, you go through the New York portal, or Florida, or and so on and so on. So depending on the state, you can file a claim in person, online, or over the telephone. And I don't know about you, but when I first tried to go ahead and sign up for the PUA, as of April 28th, it was swamped. Online, I kept getting kicked off of that. It took me 4.5 hours to go ahead and sign up for that. However, since then, it is easier to get through, but they also do have people that you can talk to on the phone. You're going, yeah, but you never get through. Well, the phones do get busy, but sometimes you can get lucky, or you pick the right time, because they're not open like 8 to 5, 5 days a week, how you would normally think. They have extended hours from 8 a.m. till 8 p.m., 7 days a week. So most people aren't even thinking about that. So maybe if you call maybe during lunch hour, or you call on the weekends because what? The weather was nice and everybody took off for the weekends. Or maybe you just call during the week. So anyway, pick your time, try it different times, see what works best. But 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Those are the hours he gave us for Pacific Standard Time. I don't know if you're from the East Coast, if it's 11 a.m. till 11 p.m. or it's the 8 a.m. till 8 p.m. East Coast time. So actually, if you're on the East Coast and you call, check it out. Please leave a comment so it'll be helpful for other people to know. But the 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., when I looked it up, was for California. But that, of course, was through the California portal. Actually, if you think about it, if it goes to the same group of people for California to New York, you call in the first 3 hours in New York, you'll probably have fewer people because Californians don't have it open. Although I don't know how exactly they're doing it. But anyway, check it out. Leave some comments for us because when we call, we're from California and that's what we'll know. So under the FPUC, the states will administer an extra $600 weekly payment to people who are eligible to receive it. So that's why when we heard it here in California, we heard that Governor Newsom was giving us an extra $600. Well, he is under the federal program. This also includes unemployment compensation for federal employees and unemployment compensation for ex-service members, as well as those collecting benefits from the following programs: Pandemic Emergency Unemployment Compensation, Pandemic Unemployment Assistance, those are the gig workers, Extended Benefits, Short-Time Compensation, Trade Readjustment Allowances, Disaster Unemployment Assistance, and Payment Under the Self-Employment Assistance Program. So if you are part of those programs, you already know it. But basically, if you're on unemployment, actually, they will probably tell you too. Most states are still waiting for guidance from the Department of Labor to implement the program and the other two programs as well. Right now, because this was written earlier, they have received some guidance. As states start to provide the extra payment, eligible people will receive retroactive payments. Actually, that was a great part, is it is retroactive. Payments go back to your eligibility date, or the date you signed, or the date your state signed an agreement to provide the benefits, whichever is later. So all states have executed agreements with the Department of Labor as of March 28, 2020. Unless the program is extended, the benefit payments will end after July 31st, 2020. So this part is really important. As you can see, it's highlighted. Under the CARES Act, states that waive their usual one-week waiting period for benefits will be fully reimbursed by the federal government for benefits paid that week, plus any associated administrative expenses. That's pretty cool. Okay. And federal law does allow considerable flexibility for states to amend their laws to provide unemployment benefits, insurance benefits, in several COVID-19 related situations. Tell you this. Okay, so this is, states can exempt, for example, pay benefits when an employer temporarily closes due to COVID-19, preventing employees from going to work. A person is quarantined and anticipates going back to work after the quarantine is over. Or third, a person stops work due to risk of COVID-19 exposure or infection to care for a family member or to homeschool their children. Under federal law, an employee doesn't have to quit to receive benefits due to COVID-19. Here's the other part is, because I have heard from people, is do this right. I've heard people go, well, what if I just do this on the side and I don't report it? Do what's right, because they will be checking. In fact, plan on them checking to see if you rightly qualified. You're always better to do it safely. Also, when I filed under the state of California, they did give, right here, it's three different situations with COVID-19. Under the state of California, they had a lot of COVID-19 related situations, and it had everything to do with your school closed, you were at home, had to take care of the kids, you're part of a group that was quarantined, you're helping somebody that's sick. I mean, there was a whole list of possible reasons, or even like you're working and your work has slowed down due to COVID-19, or your hours have been cut back due to it. But go to your portal for your state, fill out the information, and then go ahead and check, because after you've filled it out, they do have ways that you can confirm and see what is going on online. Also, I've seen information that it may take 3 weeks for you to hear what's going on. So just be patient. You can go back and check, look in the portal, know that they're working on it. And also, this is an election year, so know that your elected officials are busy working away because they know you need more stimulus. So for now, this is the Atlas Post. Are you receiving an extra $600 a week for unemployment from the federal government? We would love to know how long it took from when you applied till you started receiving it. And then for some of you, I know that you're frustrated, you're trying to get an answer. Maybe someone will leave an answer that will give you inspiration or give you an idea so that you know that, well, that is coming, because sometimes it feels like it's going into a black hole. But go ahead and take a look. The telephone number is included, so you can go ahead and call them besides checking in your portal to go ahead and find an update for that. But go ahead and take a look, because it's there. And this is the time when I guess you have to exercise patience. But go ahead, leave comments. We will